Okay, next, adiabatic process. Adiabatic process. Okay, this also four marks questions, very important. Okay, the process in which pressure and volume are changed. In this process, pressure and volume are changes at constant heat. Then in this process, the pressure and volume are changes at constant heat. That we are calling the adiabatic process. Okay, work done in the adiabatic process. Work done in adiabatic process. Now we are going to do the derivation for how much work we have done in the adiabatic process. For that, same thing, we have to consider the 1 gram of mole gas that is should be at the volume and temperature T. But these are all should be at which position? The pressure and volume should be changed at where P and V should be changed at constant heat energy. Okay, the pressure, volume, temperature, if you consider, then P and V should be at constant. So P and V should be changes or increases at where heat should be constant heat energy. Then what we can write? Adiabatic process means PV over K sum. This you have to remember, especially in the adiabatic process. Okay, next, work done. The total work done heat gas. PdV, do you know? So ideal equation. Okay, this is the equation dW is equal to PdV. Now integrate the both side. Integration, differentiation, cancel. So this you are having already. P is equal to how much you are having? PV is equal. So where is that formula? P is equal to how much you are having? RT by V. So simply we have to substitute this value there. But here volume changing from where to where actually? So volume changing from where to where? V1 to V2. So we are having this relation, so no need to do this also. This not required actually. So directly we are having PV over gamma is equal to k constant we are having. Directly you can substitute this here. What happened? dw is equal to, see what happened, p d, sorry, w is equal to integration p dv. Okay, p is equal to what, you can write directly, this is gamma, this is v, this is gamma, simply substitute volume from where to where, v1 to v2. Okay, on the gas, if you have work done on the gas, the volume is increasing from v1 to v2. Simply what I can here. We are having the integration x to the power of n dx is equal to x to the power of n plus 1 by n plus 1. Same thing we can apply here. Okay, shall I have this side? As it is, I am writing 1 minus gamma V2 minus gamma plus 1 V1 minus gamma plus 1. Okay, but we know that already PV power gamma is equal to K. So we are having here K value. Simply take this K value and substitute here. How much is there? PV. Suppose let us take here, what is there? Suppose if you take P1, V1 gamma power K. Next one, what we can take? P2, V2 gamma power K. Simply take this value and substitute here. What happened here, tell me? So, inside first multiply. K, V2 minus gamma plus 1. K, V1 minus gamma plus 1. 1 divided by 1 minus gamma. This is constant. Don't disturb this term. Okay. See, we knew that K is equal to how much is there? Suppose if you take K equal to what is the formula? P V power gamma. Next, if you take this is K is equal to P1 V1 gamma. Next, K is equal to how much you can take? P2 V2 power gamma. Take the values and substitute. K is equal to V2 is there. See how much is there? Check it. P2 next V2 gamma. V2 minus gamma plus. Okay, see what happened? This get cancelled, then 1 minus. See, finally what you got? W is equal to 1 by 1 minus gamma is equal to P2 V2 minus P1 V1. But according to ideal gas equations, what we can write? What is the formula actually? PV is equal to nRT. Yes, do you know? You don't know, this is already we know very well. So what we can take simply, P1 V1 is equal to, like that we can take. What happened? The N is equal to, if you substitute 1, then that value don't take. P1 V1 is equal to R T1. Next. R is the constant, ideal gas constant.